Bienvenidos, Ushamdi, and welcome, CTS230, Section 841 students, for the first eight-week term of the fall 2017 semester at Anne Arundel Community College. This is the Networking 3, or the Scaling Networks V6 course from Cisco Networking Academy. And this video tutorial is going to be on Chapter 2 material, coming a little behind some of the things we looked at in Chapter 3. And it's going to be a very brief video because we're going to be looking at one thing and one thing only, and that is the dynamic trunking protocol. And specifically, we're interested in that error we see when on a multi-layer 3560, we say switch port mode trunk, we end up seeing an error telling you that you can't make it a trunk port when the encapsulation is set to auto. So let's go ahead and see what that error looks like if I was to get rid of some of these windows over here. Here is the actual error, right? And this is simply a quick grab of the error when it comes up. But again, it says command rejected. An interface whose trunk encapsulation is auto cannot be configured to trunk mode. Now, it doesn't mean that it can't negotiate to become a trunk. What it means is that we cannot hard code the port with the switch port mode trunk command. In other words, the encapsulation is also going to be negotiating along with whatever the DTP mode happens to be. So let's see what that looks like from the perspective of the switch. So when I say show interface fast Ethernet 1022, and actually we want to do a show interface fast Ethernet 0122 switch port. And so when we see the output here, we're looking for a couple specific things. The first thing we're looking for is what is the administrative mode of the port? And again, this is the default, or if I was the system, the network administrator, and I had gone in and hard-coded it, it would reflect whatever I've put in there. I could say switch port mode trunk, switch port mode dynamic desirable, and whatever that setting is, it would show here under administrative mode. Now, this keyword here, auto, remember that auto and desirable, those are the two dynamic trunking protocol modes that will negotiate things. Now, you see here where it says administrative trunking encapsulation, negotiate. When we looked at the 2960s, what did it say here? It says 802.1Q, and I apologize, I'm drawing with my mouse right now. So it says 802.1Q. In other words, there is no option on the 2960s to negotiate a different trunking encapsulation. So it's 802.1Q or nothing. And therefore, when we run that switch port mode trunk command on the 2960s, since the encapsulation is not quote-unquote auto, or it's not going to auto-negotiate, is really what it's saying. It doesn't say auto because the dynamic auto is set for the administrative mode. Because again, by default on the multi-layer switches, as well as the 2960s, what is the default dynamic trunking protocol mode? It's auto, and this is on the newer equipment. And so the reason that we can conclusively say that we see that all caps A-U-T-O is because it's not set to auto negotiate. It's not because it's dynamic auto, and let's prove that right now. I've got a 3550 here. Now the 3550 is the predecessor to the 3560, and it's also a switch model, and let's go ahead and go in from user exec to privilege exec, and we're going to say show version, so we can see that this is a 3550 running IP services K9, and when I say show interface fast Ethernet 04 switch port, switch port, what do we see here? we see that the administrative mode is dynamic desirable, but we also see that it still says for the trunking encapsulation, it says to negotiate. So again, here, put a little question mark, it doesn't say auto, but it is still auto negotiate for the trunking encapsulation. So not only is it negotiating whether or not it's going to be a trunk, it is also negotiating whether or not it's going to use ISL, and if not ISL, 802.1Q, and if not 802.1Q, then it'll default back to an access port. And we saw that in class. And so let me clear the screen here and show that even on the 3550, when I go into global config, interface fast Ethernet 0, and what port were we using there? Let's use the same port, 0/4. When I say switch port mode trunk or just switch port MT, what do we see? Command rejected, an interface whose trunk encapsulation is auto. It's talking about the encapsulation when it references auto. It's not referring to the dynamic trunking protocol mode. Because if it was here on a port that's clearly dynamic desirable, it would have said an interface whose trunk encapsulation is dynamic desirable. Again, it's auto negotiate on the trunking encapsulation. The dynamic trunking protocol mode is dynamic desirable. And so hopefully that's clear. That's why on the legacy equipment, you see that it says it's simply set to auto. It means auto negotiate. And so that brings us to the root cause of the problem here, is that on the 3560 multi-layer switch, as well as the legacy 3550 multi-layer switch, we see this error because both of those switches, with the code that they're running, still support still support ISL as a trunking encapsulation. So if I said switch port trunk encap and do a question mark, you can see negotiate .1Q and ISL. If I come to the newer 3750, we end up with the same result. Interface fast Ethernet 1022, switch port trunk encapsulation, .1Q ISL negotiate. Now, I don't have a 2960 yet. I actually have one en route to add into my lab, but don't have one yet with the 15.0 code that we are using in class. But when you run this command, it doesn't even give you an option for the encapsulation. So in other words, on the 2960, when I say switch port trunk, and I do a question mark, encapsulation is not even there. Because again, the only trunking encapsulation supported on the newer hardware and the newer iOS versions is 802.1Q. ISL was Cisco's proprietary, and it's a legacy deprecated trunking protocol, trunking encapsulation at this point. And so therefore, you're not even going to see an option to configure it. And so the reason that we end up with this error when I say switch port mode trunk is because I can't, the switch is telling me here, hey, you cannot hard code this as a trunk port for the very reason that the encapsulation wants to negotiate. So the trunk port, the dynamic trunking protocol, has to be one that is going to try to, it's going to participate in negotiation. I want to be careful that I don't say initiate negotiation, because then you're going to say, well, wait a minute, dynamic auto doesn't negotiate. I'm sorry, doesn't initiate. And you're absolutely right. But dynamic desirable and dynamic auto, even when the other side is auto, they are negotiating. It's just that they don't negotiate. If both sides are auto, they do not negotiate to a trunk port. They negotiate to an access port. So I want to make sure I'm clear on that. So what the switch is telling you is that the dynamic trunking protocol mode that I have right now tells me that I'm going to be negotiating what kind of a port I'm ultimately going to be. And that's true for both the trunking encapsulation as well as the trunk what kind of a port it's going to be. Is it going to be a trunk port? Or is it going to be an access port? And so you cannot hard code the port as a trunk port when the port is still under the impression that it's going to be negotiating its encapsulation. So irrespective of the encapsulation type I choose, so here I could say switchport trunk encapsulation ISL. Now when I say switchport mode trunk, it works and there's no problem. Because again, I have conclusively and definitively defined that the encapsulation is hard coded. And so since the encapsulation is now hard-coded and there will be no auto-negotiation of the trunking encapsulation, I'm now allowed to hard-code what type of port this is going to be. And so now when I say do show interface fast Ethernet 1022, and I apologize again, I left off the all-important switch port option, now take a look. What is the administrative trunking encapsulation? Do we see that it says that it's going to negotiate? No, it is hard coded. And therefore, I'm allowed to say I am hard coding you with an administrative mode as a trunk port. So then we can do that. And if I come over here to the 3550, the same thing applies. If I were to say 802.1Q is the switchport trunk encapsulation, and then come back and say switchport mode trunk. Now when I say do show interface fast Ethernet 0/4 switchport, what do we see? The administrative trunking encapsulation has now been hard coded. So now that the encapsulation is defined, again, in other words, we can't hard code the mode of the port as a trunk before we hard code the encapsulation of the trunk or of the port, right? So again, it's like, which came first, the chicken or the egg? Well, we know right here, and we'll say that this is the egg, and the egg came first. So the encapsulation starts with an E, so we'll go with that, we'll roll with it. The egg came first. The encapsulation must come first in terms of hard coding the port as a trunk port. Again, it's going to be platform dependent, could even be iOS dependent. So check, right? It's always a good thing to check to see. But on all newer code, and I checked on a 3850 and a 3650, which are really running iOS XE, so not so much the vanilla iOS that we work with here on the Catalyst platform, but on the newer switches, it is 802.1Q. ISL does not show up, so it's not going to be there, so this isn't going to be a problem, but definitely be aware of this because you will run into this on 3560s, 3750s. Obviously, 3550s are extremely old, but very important that you know this, and even more important that you understand where you can go to look to see what the mode is going to be. Is it going to be negotiate? I'm sorry. Is it going to be trunk? Is it going to be dynamic auto, dynamic desirable? And you can see what the trunking encapsulation is going to be doing. Is it ISL? Is it .1Q? Is it negotiate? All right. Well, I just wanted to make sure that we did a quick video on that because that caused quite a bit of confusion in the lab a few weeks ago. And we spoke about it in class, but I want to make sure that we document this is the reason that you see that error. An interface whose trunk encapsulation is auto cannot be configured to trunk mode. All right, guys, thanks so much for watching. Now we're going to be moving into Ether Channel. I will see you all next Tuesday. Have a great night.